Welcome back to Star TV. On today's lovely video, we're going to be talking about why it's so important that you never allow nobody to put a time clock on your success. Right before we get into today's lovely video, make sure you guys subscribe to Star TV, where you get a new episode every week. Make sure you guys like this video, drop a comment down below, let Star know what you think, and be sure to hit that bell and press all so you will be notified each and every time Star posts a new video. Let's get right into it. So number one, ladies, never allow others to pressure you into a relationship or into a marriage prematurely due to your age. I feel like society places so many expectations and standards on women, and sometimes it's really unfair. You guys, when you're growing up, especially when you hit the age of 25 to 30, and you're not in a relationship or you're not married yet and you don't have any children, people start to question you. They start to look at you like you're the oddball. And some people even suggest that you hurry up, right? Because a lot of people place women in a box. A lot of people feel like, oh, if you're a woman, you're supposed to be married by this age, having a baby by that age. But we have to remember that every single one of us is on our own journey. And everything that we deserve will come to us and things will fall into place. And the reason why I'm speaking on this is because I'm turning 25, you guys, and I kid you not, maybe it's because I come from an African family, but I've had many of my family members recently tell me that I need to hurry up. I need to start thinking about marriage. You know, I need to start thinking about children. And I'm turning 25 within the course of 2 days. And I want to tell these people, you know, put tradition aside, put your timeline for my life aside, because in all actuality, Star has not lived yet, and I'm really not in a place where I'm ready to commit to a marriage or start a family or think about settling down. I'm at the stage in my life, you guys, where I want to travel and I want to live life. And I see a lot of women out there. I even know one particular woman, she's 29, and she always talks about marriage and kids and how most people her age have children. Most people her age are married. And so because of that, it makes people feel less than. It makes them feel like, you know, something is wrong with them or they are missing out. But I'm here to encourage women, if you're not married by 30, if you don't have a baby by 35, that is okay. Your value does not decrease. Your worth does not decrease because you know who you are in Christ. You know that your value and your worth doesn't come from a man and it doesn't come from a baby. It comes from God, and all things are working together for your good. You guys, it is not too late for you. If you're in your mid-20s or your late-20s and you're not in a relationship, it doesn't mean that your life is ending. The world is not falling apart. Everything will happen in perfect timing. And that's why I really, you know, started to find myself thinking like, you know what? I got to start checking people. I don't care if they're family. Nobody is going to pressure me into thinking about marriage or children right now while I'm young. And I want to choose to live my life in a way that makes me happy. I want to enjoy my singleness, my individuality, and my freedom. And I want to encourage women out there to do the same. Do not be in a rush. A lot of married people will tell you, you know what? I don't mean to burst your bubble, but marriage is hard. Marriage is compromise. Marriage is dying to yourself and making sure that you are making sacrifices for your significant other. Married people will tell you it's not easy. So therefore, it's nothing you should rush into due to your age or society's standards or what other people expect of you. And a lot of mothers will tell you, yeah, motherhood is a gift, but I wish I would have waited. I wish I would have traveled more. I wish I would have, you know, done other things. You know, now I need a babysitter. Now I'm not able to go out as freely. So this is not to take away from mothers, but this is just to evaluate and realize that if you're a single woman, you are blessed. Enjoy your time where you're able to go wherever you want and you don't have no children. Enjoy your time where, you know, you have all the time in the world to focus on you, because you don't have to wake up at 7 o'clock and prepare breakfast for your husband and iron his clothes. Enjoy this time for you, because you won't always have it. All in all, don't let nobody make you feel less than because you're not married or you don't have children. Don't let society force you and you rush into a relationship and you wind up with the wrong person. Don't let nobody force you into having kids by a certain age, right? Because you're worried about, you know, what other people are expecting of you. You're worried about, you know, being a certain amount of years older than your child. Don't let nobody force you into motherhood or marriage, because you just might regret it. Enjoy your season and enjoy your time, and have faith that all things are working together for your good. Not everybody is graced and anointed to be a mother and to be married in their 20s, but some people have that grace to be a mother and to be married in their 30s. For example, you guys, look at Portia Williams from The Real Housewives of Atlanta. She got married at 29, and nowadays, especially in African culture, getting married at 29 is like, wow, you waited a long time, you know? But she got married, and she married the wrong person. She got married just before 30, and she suffered in that marriage. And then she waited so many years later, and at 41, she's not old. She looks amazing. She met the love of her life. And now she's married to the right person, and she's happy, and she's thriving.
I do not miss.
And you see, I know that you two have a love that is rooted in God, and it is blessed by God. Because Portia, sometimes you are gonna have a long day at work. All the scenes aren't gonna go as you plan them to go. And you are gonna really need some words of reassurance from your husband. Words like, I'll love you forever. As long as I'm living, my baby, you'll be.
Has she, you know, fallen to society's expectations, right, and standards? After her first marriage at 29, I'm sure after that divorce, she would have hurried up and gotten married, because most women think, oh my goodness, you know, gotta have a baby before 37, gotta get married before 36. And what if she would have rushed and made another wrong choice by marrying another wrong person? But instead, she waited, and God blessed her when the time was right. And this is why I believe you should never let nobody put a time clock on your success. Let's get into tip number 2. Age means nothing when your life can change overnight. And we all feel like this, especially, you know, going on Instagram, looking at social media, right? Sometimes you can easily compare your life to other people, and you can think that it's over for you because you have not achieved a certain status by a certain age. But I want to encourage somebody. Age does not mean anything when your life can change overnight. There are so many people out here who are struggling with depression, anxiety, sadness, regret, and sorrow. There are so many people in pain because they feel like they should have been further than where they are now. They feel like they have failed themselves, and they feel like life has failed them. I don't care how old you are. It doesn't matter if you don't have a house yet, if you don't have a car. It doesn't matter if you're not married. It doesn't matter if you have not found your tribe yet. It doesn't make you any less of a woman, and it doesn't make you any less of a man. Don't think that your story and your season today will be how the rest of your life will play out. A lot of the times, you guys, how life is now, it will be completely different 5 years from now. When I look back on how my life is now compared to how it was, I would have never imagined, and I would have never guessed, that things would be the way they are now. I had absolutely no idea. And that's just an example. You never know what awaits your future. You guys, let's look at Ice Spice. Ice Spice was just a regular girl from the Bronx. She was from Fordham. And that's my area right there. You know, I grew up around here. And it's like, to go from being a regular girl, you know, going on Fordham, you know, doing what you do, going to school, coming home, shopping, and then out of nowhere, blowing up into this global star, right? She's all over on Billboard, you know, surpassing people like Cardi B and Lotto. Look at Ice Spice. Her life literally changed overnight. She had no idea what awaited her. But if she would have gave up and compared herself to other icons, if she would not have believed in herself, she would have been missing out on the very blessings that she is experiencing and enjoying today. You guys, let's also take a look at Beyoncé when she was a little girl before she made it big. Who would have known that this little girl that sings and dances and performs in talent shows and performs in her mother's hair salon, who would have known that that little girl named Beyoncé would be as big and as global and as iconic as she is today? It's just so amazing how your life can change overnight, how your life can change in a day, in a course of a few months, in a course of a few years. So the next time somebody approaches you and tries to make you feel bad for things you don't have at a certain age, I want you to look them in the eye and tell them, you don't know my story and you don't know my destiny. My life can change overnight and my life is about to change. Things are about to get better for me. You're about to hear about me, and I'm about to be all over. I want you to tell somebody, don't sleep on me, because I'm about to blow up. I want you to tell somebody, I'm the next biggest thing. You wait and you see. We have to start believing in ourselves. It don't matter if you 45, 46. Look at the guy who invented KFC. He was in his 80s. It is not over for you. It's not over for me, and it's not over for you. So I want to dare somebody to just believe for a second that their story will change and that their age is nothing but a number. Let's get into tip number 3. Don't feel guilty for not achieving a certain amount of success. You have to realize you are still young, and even if you're not young, you are doing the best you can. You guys, speaking from a humble place, it's not easy out here. Everybody is trying to make ends meet. Whether you're in college and you're a struggling college student, or you're working a 9-to-5 and you're surviving from paycheck to paycheck, it's not easy out here. Everybody has a story. Most people have struggled, and most people that struggle have a success story. Most people that are successful have a struggle story. Beyoncé has a struggle story. Drake has a struggle story. Nicki Minaj has a struggle story. That's why you should never be ashamed of struggling, because the biggest have struggled, and they have also showed us that it is possible to make it. We have to realize that yes, success is beautiful, but the journey and the pathway to get there won't be as pretty. We have to work hard, but also give yourself some grace to know you are doing the best you can. You just started that business. You might not have 500 customers. You might have to work your way up from 1 to 5 to 10 to 15 to 20. But don't put yourself down. You are doing the best you can. You just started that YouTube channel and you've been stuck on 20 subscribers for 6 months now. Know that everything will come in due timing and in due season. You keep being consistent. You are doing the best you can. You're working a 9-to-5 and you're saving money so you could get your own place. Don't compare yourself to people who have condos and houses, because you are working and you are building and you are doing the best you can. In this day and age, we can be our own biggest critics. Most of the times when people are going through grief and sadness, it's because there is a war inside of their minds. Some of our thoughts are actually voices speaking to us, and sometimes these negative voices want us to think badly about ourselves, and they want us to think badly about our situation. But every time you have a bad thought, a thought that puts you down, a thought where you're criticizing yourself, you got to speak to yourself. You got to tell yourself, I will be successful. I will work hard. I will make progress. My today won't be my tomorrow. I know my future is bright. I know that it's bigger than this. I know that I'm going to become somebody great. Sometimes we have to speak to ourselves because we are and we can be our own biggest critics. But today, let's choose to change the narrative. And last but not least, tip number 4, God is the author of time. He has a plan for you and he has a plan for me. Do not rush. Most people are so anxious and worried about their life and about how things will play out because they don't believe that God has a plan for them. Everybody wants to plan out their own life. Everybody wants to manifest whatever they want. Nobody wants to pray and see, you know what? What plan does God have for me? Maybe God's plan might be bigger than what I'm planning for myself. Maybe God's plan might be even greater than what I'm trying to manifest, what I'm trying to bring into existence. See, when you're thinking of God and you're trusting his timing, when people approach you and they say, oh, you're not in a relationship. Oh my goodness, you're not too far from 30. You're not married yet. You know, hurry up. You know, time's not on your side. When people rush you, you look at them like they're crazy because you're thinking to yourself, do you not know my God? Do you not know that my God is the author of time, the beginning and the end? He has already written my story. He exists in timing and outside of time and eternity. If my God has the clock in his hand, why should I be in a rush when everything that is meant for me is already aligned and orchestrated to play out in this story called life? And that I'm in this chapter, but this chapter will be so different from my next chapter. You guys catch my drift? When you're trusting God for the order of your life and you're trusting him to bring to you the things that you pray for and the things that you desire, when people try to rush your success and put a timeline on your life, you just pay them dust. You don't pay any mind to them because you know that what God has for you is for you. So I want to encourage somebody. I don't care how old you are. It doesn't matter what you don't have. Know that God is the author of time. What he has for you, that blessing, that breakthrough with your name on it, it won't pass you by. Have faith, believe, and wait, and never become impatient with God, because God is decorating that blessing. He's putting things together behind the scenes. He's working on it. You know, you have to think of it like this. When you're baking cookies, can you just eat the dough? No, you have to cut the dough into pieces and then you place it on the aluminum foil and then you place it in the oven on 350 degrees and you wait 30 minutes. The cookies have to be baked. They have to mold into the proper position. They have to harden so they can be tasty and so they can be edible. That's how God is preparing your blessing. Some of you, your blessing is baking in the oven, but you're so impatient, you're losing hope. Now you want to do things on your own. And right before God is about to present your blessing, you gave up and you did things yourself. And that's why life is falling apart, because you didn't wait on God's timing. So I want to encourage you guys to wait on God for that amazing husband. Wait on God for that beautiful baby. Wait on God to bless you with that house. Wait on God to bring the right friends and the right tribe in your life. Stop rushing him, because what he is preparing could almost be ready if you don't give up. don't lose faith. I love you guys. Never let nobody put a time clock on your success. Never let anybody create a timeline of events for your life. You're blessed. You're beautiful. God has a plan for you, and it is not over. I love you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. And until next time, Star will see you soon. Peace.